Dear students, let's start the topic of semiconductors. In this section, we'll first discuss about the semiconductor materials. Let's first write down some facts about these materials. We can write that these are material used to design devices which control flow of charge particles. Inside the materials. Basically, when we talk about the flow of charge particle inside the material, these are electrons or electron deficient places, which are generally termed as holes, which we'll study in later part of the section. So, mainly semiconductors are material which are used to design devices which control flow of charge particles inside the material. Another fact we can write when we talk about such devices, and we can write these devices based on semiconductor materials can govern flow of charges for some specified processes. We'll discuss about such processes in later part of this chapter, and we'll study such devices which are based on semiconductor material. These devices can govern the flow of charges as per the need of a specific process. And we can also keep one thing in mind, which most of you are aware about, that most of electronic equipments and gadgets are based on semiconductor devices. Almost all kind of electronic equipments in your surrounding, like television, refrigerator, CD and DVD players, MP3 players and all mobile phones, these all gadgets and equipments are based on semiconductor devices. So, before starting with the study of semiconductor devices, let's first discuss about the classification of materials. About classification, again, technically we'll discuss in detail, but when we talk just about classification of solid materials available in nature, we can simply say there are three types of materials in which, or three kinds of materials which are available in form of solids, or all kind of materials divided in three major categories, which are: number one is conductors, number two is insulators, and number three is semiconductors. The basic difference in the three is conductors are those which conduct electricity. Almost all metals fall under the category of conductors, and we can write for conductors their alpha is positive. Alpha is the temperature coefficient of resistance, which we already studied in the section of current electricity. And this says that if alpha is positive, that means with the temperature, the resistance or resistivity of conductor increases and its conductivity decreases. Insulators are those which do not conduct electricity. We can write there is no conduction exists in case of insulators. Semiconductors are those which also we can write conduct electricity at room temperature. With their temperature coefficient of resistance is negative. That's implies that if temperature increases, the resistivity of semiconductor decreases or their conductivity increases. So, just this difference is quite important to be kept in mind, that for conductors or in normal metals, with temperature, their conductivity decreases, and in case of semiconductors, with temperature, their conductivity increases.